All right, go.
Yeah, so I know you. Yeah, guys. So, but this time, guys, is going to be a little different. Why is that? Because I'm going to break it down. I wrote on this whiteboard here to really educate you guys, because I know there's different type of learners, guys. We're going to forget about this. There's different type of learners, guys. I know some people.
Of credit.
What is type of credit? 10%, guys. Installment loans and revolving loans. Right now, it won't hurt you too much if you have some revolving loan. So, guys, with that being said, now down below, I want you guys to go ahead and comment down below, what is the difference between installment loans and revolving loans? Yes, what is the difference between installment loans and revolving loans? If you don't know it, I'm going to give you guys 5 seconds to comment. All right, guys. The difference, guys, installment loans is... I'm going to give... Guys, down below, I need... Because I thought it was alive or something. But.
Yeah, you can be the greatest. You can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world. You can beat the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up. You can beat the clock. Yeah. You can move a mountain. You can break rocks. You can be a master. Don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
What's going on, y'all? It's your boy John the Trainer. Welcome to John the Trainer's Finance Class. Yes, what's the topic today, guys? Credit. As y'all can see, how is your credit calculated? How is your credit score calculated? That is the question of the day today, and that is what we're going to answer. I don't know if you guys knew it or not, but there's about 43 million people in America right now with less than perfect credit score. Yeah, it's a catastrophe. I don't know what's happening. Did you know about like 80 million people are losing their jobs right now in 2020 or last week, 2020? People know credit is important. People know how important it is, and they know that they need it to survive in this world, but they don't have money to go ahead and get their credit fixed. But it's okay, guys. As long as you have the knowledge of how you can get it fixed and you know how important it is, then that will motivate you guys to take the first step and get your credit fixed. So with that being said, guys, I know I covered this topic before, how is your credit score calculated, on my YouTube channel and everything like that. If you haven't watched it yet, John the Trainer, go watch it on my YouTube channel. But, this time, guys, is gonna be a little different. Why is that? Because I'm gonna break it down. I wrote on this whiteboard here to really educate you guys, because I know there's different type of learners, guys. We're gonna forget about this. 35%, guys, is payment history. Payment history, how well you pay your stuff on time. I'm gonna give you guys a tip. Right here, we're gonna drop a lot of golden nuggets that you guys can take home with you. Always pay your big stuff first. By big stuff, what do I mean? I mean your car bills, your insurance, I mean your house bill, your mortgages. I mean stuff like that. Pay those first, because those, you miss one payment, will totally bring your score down. And we don't want that to happen. 30%, guys, is capacity amount owed. How much you owe, right? A lot of people think since they have $600 limits of their credit card or $2,000 limits, they think the money on their credit card is their money. I'm here to tell you guys that it's not your money. You're borrowing it. So when you borrow something, you have to pay it back. And if you do not pay it back, you're a thief. And what that happens, they can't take you to jail for it, but they drop your score. So now other big banks and other companies know to not work with you or lend you money because you're not going to pay them off. You just destroyed your reputation. A lot of people do that. Me, myself, that happened to me so much time. So don't feel bad. Don't feel like I'm bashing y'all. It happens to all of us. All right? So, guys, 15%, we got length of credit. How long you leave your credit open for? If you leave your credit open for a good amount of time, I always tell my clients 1 to 3 years, leave your credit open. Even though you don't want it open, use it 3 to 6 months just to keep it active. Right, just to keep it active, and after that you can go ahead and close it. But do not close it because there's charge-offs. It counts as a charge-off every time you close your credit card. It counts as a charge-off. So go ahead and leave it active for about 1 to 3 years. Just for, let's say, just to keep your reputation clean and just to show them that you've been using the card. So now you do not have to get a charge-off or a negative point on your score, on your credit card account. All right? So next, we got 10%. New credit inquiry, Doc. New credit inquiries, it happens to every credit card you open is an inquiry on your score. I didn't know if you guys knew that. Yes, it's an inquiry on your score. I always tell my clients you can have 2 to 5 credit cards. I even know people with 7 credit cards. But the thing is, if you're responsible with it, then you would not get in trouble. So just be responsible with your credit and have the amount that you know that you can pay off. Don't overdraft them. Don't go ahead and owe so much on them. Don't even go ahead and close your credit cards because that's going to be a charge. Last but not least, we got, boom, type of credit. Yes, guys, type of credit. Down below, guys, I want you guys to comment, what is the difference between installment loan and revolving loan? And if you do not know, stick around. I'm going to tell you right now. Installment loan, guys, is the loan. No, installment loan is anything that's installed, it does not go away. For example, your car bill, your mortgage, your house, right? Your student loan. I know teachers that have been teaching for 40 years and still are in student loan debt. Did you know that student loan debt is the number one debt in America? It's crazy, right? And revolving loans is the opposite of installment loan. If installed means stick and stay, and if installed means stick and stay, then what do you think revolving means? That means go away. So that means that if you pay it off, or it won't stay on your credit score as long, or also it won't hurt you too much if you have some revolving. It won't hurt you too much if you have some revolving loan. So guys, with that being said, revolving loan is anything that revolves, mean it continues, guys. So that's easy. You can take it off your score. It's not going to hurt you too much like the installment loan. Remember, 35% of it is installment loans. How well do you pay your installment loan? How well do you pay your house bills? How long do you pay your car, your mortgages, your loans? That is the big thing, and that is what's going to determine your whole credit score. Alright, guys, I hope I broke it down well enough for you guys. I appreciate y'all for watching, guys. Stay tuned for the next videos coming up. With that being said, guys, always remember this: cash is king and credit is queen, and she runs the house. With that being said, stay positive, keep pushing. One love. See y'all at John the Trainer's finance class. Peace.